Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, I'm going to show how to make these 3D titles tracked into your scene. So to make this effect happen, we're going to use two different tools to do that. But first, I'm going to take my 5-second raw footage clip and just make it into a composite shot. The first tool that I will use will be the Foundry camera tracker. So opening up the Foundry folder and then dragging the camera tracker into the raw footage, I will go ahead and select track features first. Then I will select solve camera. And then I will select create scene. Now that the scene is created, if I go to a second view and make the second view, say for example, a perspective shot, I have an idea of where the camera is and whether or not it's correctly moving. So the first thing that I want to do is go ahead and find a point here in the shot that I want to use as my center of the universe point. Back in a single view with a camera tracker selected and the selection tool highlighted, I will go ahead and select this point, and then opening up this menu, I will say create a new point. This new point will in fact become my center of the universe. So I'm going to go ahead and rename that center. I will disconnect that from parenting to the first point or the primary point, and then I will parent the primary point to my center of the universe point. Now that this is the center of the universe and everything surrounds it, I will go ahead and reset that point to the center of the grid. So now if I go ahead and open back up the secondary thing, you can see that this is here, and you can also see that the camera is moving correctly and that it is in the right position when it comes to looking at this entire scene. So having done that, we'll go back to single view and we'll go ahead and turn off the floor planes in the motion path here. And then we will go ahead and select new layer and type in my text, making a few adjustments along the way. Now that this has been selected, I will use the second tool in the arsenal, which will not be to make this into a three-dimensional, but instead I will use under generate the 3D extrusion layer only. And then under position, I will transform from the center of the universe. So now you can see that it is actually there. And all I need to do now is just make some changes. I'm going to open up rotation first. And I'm just going to go ahead and rotate this so that it is standing fairly straight up. And I probably will turn it so that it is matching with that building. I think I will go ahead and lift it. And I'm going to go ahead and expand that to say 50 or so, maybe 60. And then when I'm happy, I will go ahead and test that out just to be sure that it looks good. And it does. I think I like it. And it seems to be tracking nicely. So now what I will do is I will come to environment map and I will select as the environment map the raw footage. The pre-blur is set pretty high at 50 right now, but if I were to take that all the way down to zero, you can see that that's an exact perfect mirror of the environment. What I'll do is just add a little bit to that, not a lot, maybe 10. And now I have my three-dimensional title tracked into this scene.